Good afternoon. Today's video is going to be about advanced Spotlight searches. We're going to search for system files, search for it by type, search for it by sizes, show you different ways of searching for things, and then how to apply some of these searches within the search bar so you don't have to use the advanced search options within Finder. First, search for a system file. I've got a Finder search here for com.apple.finder. Now this is a preference file that controls how Finder looks. If you've watched some of my previous videos, you'll notice that I actually change these preferences quite a lot. Now I want to view this file just out of interest. However, if I search for this file, I won't actually see it within this list. It's not present. This is because Finder is excluding system files. However, we can include it. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on this plus symbol below the toolbar. You'll notice we can these options come up. We're going to first select Other. And now there's a big long list of things we can search for. I'll go through these in a bit more detail later. So let's search for System. You only have to type a couple of letters in. And it says Attribute System Files. Now this is a search for our system files that we want. Press the In menu checkbox on the right to add it to the menu. This makes it an easy option to select. Now, there's now an option here that says system files aren't included. We'll select the drop down and go, are included. 2 seconds later, a whole new list of Finder options have appeared. And I can see it now, com.apple.finder.plist has now appeared. It's now searching within, as you can see at the bottom here, a system folder, in this case the library file. Quite a good way of actually finding system files and folders if you want to quickly edit them or quickly look at them, or you're just interested in what file is actually included on your system. Finder is so good at searching for files and folders that it will bring back absolutely everything. I've searched for a screenshot in this example in this Finder window, and the list is absolutely phenomenal. There's hundreds of items here. I've got these two images on my desktop. One's a JPEG file and one's a PNG file. Now, I know that I'm looking for a screenshot which is an image. So let's narrow down our searches to find the image file. So let's click on this plus button again. You'll notice here we've got kind is any. That's why it's bringing back every single result. So let's select image. Well, immediately the list has jumped down. We're only getting images. Now it's also selecting every single image that it can find. Notice we've got our JPEG image, our PNG image, and a GIF image that just happens to be populated in the list. I can now use this option to narrow down the search even more. This time it's only selected PNG images. Now I've still got quite a lot because screenshot is generally quite a good term. However, we've only got 211 items here at the bottom, whereas before we had 4,000 items. Now, it's far easier to search for 200 items than it is for 4,000 items. Spotlight is a powerful tool in that it actually records a hell of a lot of information about a file. One of these is file size. Now, we can use this to our advantage to find really big files or really small files. In the case of really big files, we can actually find the big ones and delete them and save ourselves a bit of hard drive space. Now from the menu option again, we can go over and search for size. I've actually searched for it a couple of times so it appeared in that list. And we can select it and press OK. Now it gives us various options. Equals to a specific size. Well, I don't really remember the exact file size, so that's not very useful. Is less than. Now that is useful. Is greater than. Is very useful. And is not. Well, jury's out on that one. Let's select is greater than. From the drop down list, let's select gigabyte and let's put in 1 gigabyte. Well, I've only got two files on my Macintosh HD drive that are bigger than a gigabyte, iMovie and MATLAB. Well, that's not very useful. I kind of use those two, particularly iMovie. So let's put in 0.5. Well, we're still getting some applications, but let's go down to 0.1 gigabyte. Also known as 100 megs. Well, now we're getting quite a few sort of disk images, cache files, and other various documents, industrial placement report at nearly 200 megs. And I can go down and delete these files and save myself a bit of hard drive space. Now you can also use this to find really small files, so let's say less than 100 kilobytes. Well, there isn't that many, 1,000 kilobytes. Well, a lot of these 2, 3, 4 kilobytes add up to a lot of space, so you can go around and delete these if you don't want them. Actually, there's so many, my Finder window's actually crashed. So you can use sort of the sizes option to find files within a specific size range and then delete them or find them or move them. This list that I keep referring to within this drop down list has many, many different options. For example, if you know a specific attribute about a file that you want to search for, we can actually find it. So let's say, for example, you know it was created on a certain date, you can have the created option. If you knew that the duration of your movie was 457 seconds, you can have the duration length. There's plenty on this name, such as file name, file size, as I've alluded to previously, sort of the group ID of a file, that's quite specific. Now if you've used a GarageBand file, for example, you can add an instrument and you can search for that instrument. There's all sorts on this list, ISO, speed for images, latitude and longitude if you know where it was taken. Now that is very clever if you knew where that is. Oh, what else is on this list? Name, that's pretty obvious. Owner, who actually made the file, owned the file. So the number of pages in a document. If you knew that there's a document that's 500 pages in length, you can add this option to the list. Now you can either select them in, now you'd have to select them individually, or you can use the checkbox on the right to add them to the menu. That's if you use them quite often and you want to refer back to them more than once. Now you can actually use more than one option modifier in this case to find more than one file at a time. So let's say we select the kind as an image. Well, it's going to bring back every single image it finds on my desktop. Let's select PNG files because they tend to be quite big. Let's select the plus button again. When we do that, we get another window option. So we can go file size, and this time from the list, we'll go greater than, let's select megabyte, greater than 1 megabyte. Well, there's a lot of 1 megabyte files that we can choose from. Let's find some recent ones. So let's go from the list, created date is after, or let's pick a date, let's pick after the 30th of April. Well, now we're narrowing down this list to 60 items, and we can keep doing this more and more. We can add, for example, system files, we can add another line, and let's select from the list, we want to have the longitude of X or Y, or the latitude. If we know this information, we can then search for it. Now this is a very powerful way of finding a file if you know what it is, but you can't exactly find it by name, for example. There's plenty on this list we can go around and delete, for example, or we can then find these files and remember what we've done. I've previously shown how you add the plus button here to find a file by the drop down list. Now you can actually search for it within the search dialog box itself. If you type in kind with a colon and then type in JPEG, it'll only bring your JPEG files up, and that's quite useful. Now you can also do multiple things. For example, if you type in date and type in today's date, which happens to be 30th of the 5th, the 13th, well, it only returns one JPEG file from today, which happens to be my screenshot file that I took earlier at the beginning to illustrate my point. Now this is a quicker way of actually searching for things, because this option, if I copy it to my desktop, copy it to my clipboard, will also appear within Spotlight itself. So there's multiple ways of actually searching for files. Now the quicker, more customizable way, and the way you always get it right, is to use these plus buttons and advanced search options to find the files you want. However, if you learn that kind equals kind colon JPEG finds the image that you want, you're pretty much sorted. Spotlight search is immensely powerful. It will find every single file on your computer. Now, to help you narrow down the search results, There are plenty of options to help you do this. If you have enjoyed this video, please subscribe, as I'll be producing more videos in the future and would love you to join me.